Coming home from Krakow, I met a young lad on his way to Glasgow for work. His whole family were seeing him off to his new stead, greeting and laughing at Yens. He told me he had a job all lined up. He would stay a few years and send Silla home. He was worried about his English, but I told him not to fret, for we didn't speak English anyway. The walk. The walk is along the bank of the loch, heed bent under the torrent, no seeing, no caring, just trudging. The mud is slurping, squelching, dragging at my feet, pulling me down, making each step heavy, and that slow. The rain is beating down, drizzling under my collar, insinuating itself into my boots, soaking every inch of me. The sun shudders into view, healing, drying, listening, lickening my stick, minding me of why I'm here, coming home to you. Fast lane under yont. Our visitors went to the house. We tack the road with them. A smirring spittle softens the air. Through Glen Fruin, a squinty wee road slews and jinks its way into my heat as I tour guide through old battles. Nowadays, a firing range. Forbidden signs dinna put off the glens that soar abin us. They're done funer at the Braunus, but stammy gastered at Fastlane, clarting the shore. At the heft we gowp at the loch, where a kraken lurks, surrounded by its navy of cranes. Razor wire glints off from the hoof of the grey reaper. The smell is turned to bladder. Nae words. The lassie puts the dainty chini cup between us on the blue beard cloth. I fumble it to my moo, my muckle neve making a harsh of the practice, whilst you hod it fair pernickety like. Yens our bonds would he met, but now on blue clay is a notion that pierces us. We sit on the rain shore, at odds with one another. I lang to cleek conscience there, but all you do is heist your cup to me like a skull, and I will know what.